friends, how are you all? Hope all are keeping well. I am Pragya. I welcome you to physics class. Today we will discuss the chapter energy. Before starting the chapter energy, let us discuss the concept of work. Okay? Here, the definition, while discussing the definition of work, we say that work is said to be done. But whenever other cases, definition, this one is defined as, we tell like this. But in this case, we tell work is said to be done when the force applied on a body makes the body move from one place to another. It means that one here, two concepts we are getting. Work is when work is said to be done, when force is applied on the body. So, first factor will be force is applied on the body. Second one is makes the body move from one place to another place. It means that one, there is a displacement of the body. Okay, so this will be the concept. Now let us see here. This is the body. Body will be here. Initially, body is at here. It moving with velocity, or it is body is here. Force is applied on the body. From this position, body moves to this position. Let it be from this position. It is moving from this position. Let it be. The distance it is moving s, and force is applied on the body. This is the initial position. Let it be initial position of the body. This is the final position of the body. So here we are getting concept is said to be done when force is applied on the body. Force is applied on the body and body displaces one place to another place. Okay. So now let us see that. What should be the condition for the, so here we can write condition for work done. Here condition for work done, what should be the condition for work done? First condition, force must be applied on the body. What will be the second condition? There must be displacement of the body. Displacement of the body. Okay, so keeping these two in mind, the derivation or the formula for work done equal to work done equal to force into displacement. So otherwise we can write W equal to Fs. Clear? So here condition will be force must be acting on the body. And there should be the change in position. Whenever there will be change in position, that is known as displacement of the body. Okay, so what is the formula we are getting? The formula we are getting W equal to F into S. And one thing remember, work done is always a scalar quantity. What is a scalar quantity? Scalar quantity means only this has only magnitude. Scalar quantity here, this one is only magnitude, no direction. Okay, so that is why this one is a scalar quantity. If we are discussing first the W equal to Fs, let us see that one here. We are getting W equal to F into S. So, at what condition work can be done? When there will be force, there will be displacement. We knew that one. So, at what condition no work will be done? Condition for no work done. If we are discussing condition for work done, we will discuss now condition for no work done. First one will be, there will be no displacement. If there will be no displacement, S equal to 0, obviously W equal to Fs equal to 0. Okay? Second case, no force acting on the body. So when no force is acting on the body, obviously that time no work will be done. Okay, so remember this, what is displacement? Displacement equal to displacement equal to final position minus initial position. This is known as displacement. So, condition for no work done. For example, a ball is there. Let it be a body I am keeping. Let it be here. Okay. Here, no force is acting on the body. If there will be force act on the body, then only body will displace. But it is at rest. No work is done. Now, force is applied on the body. Body displaces. It will be work will be done. Another one, let it be a wall is there. A big stone is there. You are applying the force. Force is applied on the body. But there will be no displacement in this case. Do you think work will be done? No. No work will be done at that time. Okay. Now let us see that one. If I am taking W equal to Fs, what will be the unit of work done? So, unit of work done. Here, W. So, unit for work done equal is joule. Unit of work done equal to joule. So, how to write this one? This one equal to joule is equal to force. What is the unit of force? This one is Newton. What is that unit? This one equal to, this one is for force, this one is equal to work done, this one equal to meter. This one is for displacement. So joule equal to Newton meter. It can be for work done. Okay, so here what we can write for defining unit of work, a Newton meter, 1 Newton meter equal to 1 joule. Okay, so here 1 Newton meter equal to 1 joule. Usually we represent work done, a unit of work done as joule only. We write that one as joule. So here joule equal to Newton meter. Joule equal to Newton meter. But we represent work done in the form of joule. Now let us solve one numerical. Question is given. Calculate the work done by a body when a force of 10 Newton displaces a body through 5 meter. So what is the data given? Data given, F equal to 10 Newton and S equal to 5 meter. As we know, W equal to Fs, so F equal to 10, this one equal to 5, this answer will be 40 joule. So, work done by a body will be 40 joule. This one will be answer. Now we will discuss what is energy. Energy is nothing but the capacity to do work. How the a body can do work, or the capacity of a body to do work, is known as energy. And there are different type of energy. Let it be electrical energy, let it be light energy, let it be heat energy. So there are different, so many different type of energies are there. But in our course, we will discuss here mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. Okay, so mechanical, so this one is mechanical energy. Now we will go for the concept of mechanical energy. So here in mechanical energy, in our course, this mechanical energy is divided into two parts. One is kinetic energy, one is kinetic energy, another one is potential energy. One is kinetic energy, another one is potential energy. Now, the word meaning of kinetic means it is moving. So here, let us write down energy possessed by the body. Energy possessed by a body due to its motion is called kinetic energy. But what happens in case of potential energy? This potential energy, energy possessed by the body here, energy possessed by a body due to its position or configuration. Under configuration, it can be also shape. Is known as potential energy. Okay, so one by one we will discuss here. So what is that one? Mechanical energy, it is the capacity to do work. For us, mechanical energy we will consider. Mechanical energy, it is of two types. One is kinetic energy, another one is potential energy. So kinetic energy, energy possessed by a body due to its motion. When body is moving, energy possessed by the body is kinetic energy. But when body, it is at its position, due to its position or its configuration, otherwise it can be your shape, it is known as potential energy. So individually we will discuss. So first of all, we will discuss what is kinetic energy. So now we will go for kinetic energy. Here in the kinetic energy, what is the condition? Here body must be in motion. Okay, so now let us see what is the formula for kinetic energy. This kinetic energy, it is usually we represent as Ke, or we represent as K is equal to half m v square, where m mass of the body, v velocity of the body. Okay, so kinetic energy is equal to half mv square, where m equal to mass of the body and v equal to velocity of the body. Now let us see, if I am, what will be the condition for what, on what conditions the kinetic energy depends? So kinetic energy K equal to half mv square. So kinetic energy depends on bit 1, kinetic energy directly proportional to mass of the body, more will be mass, more will be kinetic energy. Second, kinetic energy is directly proportional velocity of the body. More is the velocity, more will be the kinetic energy. Okay, so here now let us go for the unit. What is the unit of kinetic energy? First of all, let us see what is the unit of energy, then we will go for kinetic energy. What is the unit of work done? Unit of work done is joule. Now also unit of energy also joule. Okay, it can be represented as joule. Kinetic energy is joule. Now let me go for one of the numerical based on kinetic energy. Question is, a body of mass 50 gram move with a velocity of 5 meter per second. Find the kinetic energy of the body. Now here mass of the body is given. Mass of the body is given 50 gram. We cannot take it gram. We have to convert to kg. Okay. So here 50 divided by 1000. So this one will be 5 by 100. So 0.05 kg. Velocity given V equal to 5 meter per second. Then what will be its kinetic energy? Kinetic energy equal to half mv square. So half mass equal to how much? Let me write here. Half mass equal to 5 by 100 into velocity. Velocity equal to 5 into 5. Okay. So how much I am getting here? 125 divided by 200. I am not touching 100. I have to go for other calculation. So this one will be 6 12. This one will be 2.5. here this one will be 0.625 joule. Okay.